for inspiration.
Hi, good morning and welcome to the Golden Girls. How are you, girls?
Fine, thanks.
You don't seem fine. I'm telling you off air.
Too much stress at the minute.
I had some foul language then, but still, never mind. Right, that was Madonna getting to the groove, going out here to Bernie, Boopy Bailey. It's your niece, isn't it?
It is my niece. Oh, is just getting over a kidney transplant.
Right.
She's doing fine.
She's doing all right, yeah?
Yeah, she is. She's doing great.
Right, nice one. Right, come on, let's get on with the 80s. Let's
get
the
80s. We talk about 80s. If we talk about fashion first, which all us women love.
As you can tell.
You're not a woman.
No.
Do you remember the shell suits?
Yes.
Oh, good God. When you think of them now, you think, well, what did I do?
What did I do? I was saying to Archie about this, you know, shell suits.
Shell suits, yeah. They were so easy to wash and wear, weren't they, you know? But, yeah. But in the early 80s, our fashion became somewhat subdued in colours. We had lots of browns and creams, I remember that. And also a period of incredible creativity. We did lots of different things, like sweatshirts, jeans, sneakers, leg warmers, and short neck skirts, like I went to the rendezvous.
I've seen you at a rendezvous, that wig on. It didn't look like you.
Yeah, no, it didn't.
It looked like Vicky.
Did it?
Yeah.
Because I had dark hair. And lots of women use their appearance to portray their ability, power and authority in their working lives. Light coloured lipsticks and dark, thick eyelashes. A bit like Dusty Springfield in the 60s.
Yes.
Yeah?
They say old-fashioned
rejersey. Well, everything does, don't it? Everything goes round and it comes back again and, you know.
Does anybody remember what December 8th, does it mean it to anything to anybody? December the 8th, 1980.
December the 8th, 1980. What are you messing with the mic for?
You got it all slanted.
What are you bloody messing with a bleeding mic for, aren't they? December the 8th, no, does it mean out to you?
No.
It was John Lennon, founder member of the Beatles and one of the most beloved and famous music legends of our time, died on December the 8th, 1980. After being shot 4 times by a crazed fan in the carriageway of his New York City apartment building.
Yeah.
Many of the events that led up to his tragic and untimely death remain unclear, and decades after his murder, people still struggle to understand what motivated his killer, who was 25-year-old Mark David Chapman, to pull the trigger on that fateful night.
You know why he said he did it? Because in the 60s, I think it was 1965, John Lennon said the Beatles was bigger than Jesus. Yeah, and I reckon that's why he did it.
It was a sad loss.
It's still inside him now, isn't it?
Yeah.
You'll never get out of him, will
you? No, I never will.
I know.
Quite strange. Things we had like with the music in January. Please Don't Go, Casey and the Sunshine Band. Oh, I love that.
Yeah, I do. We're playing that today.
February, Do That to Me One More Time.
Yep.
Please.
Oh, here we are. She's at it already. She's still. Soon come round.
April, Call Me, Blondie. March, Another Brick in the Wall, Pink Floyd, fantastic.
That must be one of the biggest single-selling singles of the 80s, I reckon, don't you?
Funky Town, remember that? Lips UK,
yes, what you set me to.
Funky Town, yeah. December, just like starting over, John Lennon, as you're saying now, you know. And Let's Get Physical with Olivia Newton-John.
Yes, Olivia Newton-John. On that note, should we go for a song?
We will,
before we start talking all the way and giving all the show out in one hit. Let's go to a song, A Bit of Guns and Roses, Sweet Child of Mine.
Yes.
I like this.
Yeah. We'll be right back.
do we go now? Where do we go?
Brilliant song,
though. I love that song, yeah.
And if we get a little bit into politics, which we won't start fighting about, but the 1980s saw socio-economic change due to advances in technology and the beginning of globalisation.
Globalisation, eh?
And the AIDS epidemic became recognised in the 80s.
The AIDS.
And has since killed an estimated 39 million people. And that's up to 2013.
Is it?
You wouldn't think that, would you? So many people.
No.
Global warming became well known as the scientific and political community in the 80s.
Yeah.
And Ethiopia witnessed widespread famine. Do you remember that?
Yeah,
and
I remember.
Live Aid did the concert, didn't they, in 1985.
Bob Geldof.
Yeah.
Do you like him?
No, I don't like the way he was with Brexit.
What about anyway. Do you like Bob Geldof?
I do.
You do?
Yeah.
What about Bono?
Because if you say that to me, I think, is this something to do with Cher?
She's having one of them.
You're having one of them. You're having a moment, aren't you? I wouldn't say a moment, you're having a
it's
moment.
He's going through the stress.
Oh, dear me.
It's not the same one.
No.
It's in U2. This is the one who begs. I want to tell you something about Bono now.
Go on, you know
Bono it. From U2, yeah. Don't mind for money off the poor. When you're spending £5,000 on pink tinted sunglasses.
Oh, for God's sake.